Hello students, how are you all? Hope you all are fine. So today we are going to begin with the next topic, a true story of sea turtles. Kindly remove your textbook, page number 30. Now children, if you look at this, these are what? These are all endangered species. That means these are at the verge of their extinction. So children, in this chapter also, the writer mentions how he and his volunteers saved the sea turtles by involving villagers in the protection of the local species. The author was shocked at the condition of the sea turtles in Maharashtra. He devised an excellent plan by involving villagers in the protection and the conservation of the local species, and in order to make the project sustainable, the volunteers developed the concept of the turtle festival or Kasav Mahotsava, an opportunity for tourists to witness the unique spectacle of the hatchlings rushing out to the sea. This means more business for the villagers. Now the villagers realize that the tourism can be a source of income. Tourists bring in money, and in order to earn that money, it was important to protect the turtle hatchlings. Sayadri Nisarga Mitra, the author's organization, believing that it is only the local villagers who can ultimately offer excellent protection to the local species, entrusted the project to the forest department, the gram panchayat, the villagers, and their turtle friends club. So it is a true story. So let us move ahead. In this picture, we find it is a white light sea eagles. We were surveying the white-billed sea eagles in the summer that year. We meet the author along with his friends. As we roamed the coast, one of the volunteers in our team saw some shallow pits with a white eggshells nearby. Inquiries with the villagers revealed that they were turtle eggs. This came as a surprise. We had never came across the turtle eggs in our walks along the beaches of Konkan in all these years. The author was also surprised to see the shells of the turtle eggs. We learned that the beach where we had found the eggshells had been seen to the public for nearly 1 month after people smuggling silver bricks were brought in that area, but what we learned further shocked us to the core. From the in-depth, we were shocked to see that how it was. We were surprised to see that the whole beach was being sealed. The reason for it, they were trying to find out what was the reason behind it. So ultimately they found the reason. Turtles nest along the entire coastline of our state. There are few people in every village who keep combing the beach. Combing the beach means what? That the beach and the intertidal zone where they go on looking for certain things. So they used to comb the beach for what purpose? They used to comb the beach for the purpose of the eggs which they used to get from the turtles. In the early hours of the morning throughout the year, when the female turtle comes on the shore to nest and to lay eggs, she leaves behind a trail just like a track. If you observe this picture, you will find that the turtle lays behind a track of wheels, like a track of wheels, so that anybody can follow. The egg hunters follow this trial, so that it was very easy for the egg hunters to follow the trial right up to the nest, which is about half a meter deep. Till the nest, the egg hunters used to follow, and then the author is describing about the nest. It was about half a meter deep. They dig up the nest and steal all 100 to 150 eggs that are laid inside. These eggs are then either eaten or are sold in the market. If the turtle is spotted while it is still laying eggs, it is allowed to live till laying is over. As soon as the eggs are laid, it is caught and then killed and eaten. This ruthless practice is observed in all the parts of the world. So what we find here, that these hunters, they wait till the eggs are being laid, and when the eggs are being laid, they just kill it and then store all the eggs which are eaten up or being sold in the market. However, in India, sea turtles have been given protection by including them under the Schedule 1 of Indian Wildlife Protection Act 1972. So this endangered species is also given the protection under the Indian Wildlife Protection Act 1972. That means that the turtles have been given as much as protection as tigers. The turtles are being given as much as protection as the tigers are given. Therefore, all this business of gathering turtle eggs and killing turtles is carried on in a secret. So they don't do all this openly, but they do it in a secret manner, in a hush-hush manner. Now, the meaning of hush-hush manner, if you see, is that now whenever you do certain act which you all know that it is incorrect, so they do it in a very confidential manner. So that is known as a hush-hush manner. And the hatchling is the young animal that recently emerged from the egg. So here, the information was distressing. We began to think seriously about it. We decided to undertake a project for the protection and the conservation of the turtles and their nest in Maharashtra. So the author decided that we will take care of all of them. We had no experience regarding sea turtles. So first of all, we undertook a study of turtles. They did not had any experience with the turtles. So the first thing was the study of the turtles. We contacted institutes that work for protection of turtles in India. The next step was launching a turtle protection campaign at Velas, Taluka, Manjangad, District Ratnagiri, as shown here. This was done with the support and the cooperation of the Forest Department. As a part of the campaign, a few local people were specially appointed to look for turtle nests on the beach in the morning. When they came across the nest, they had to carefully remove the eggs from the nest and bury them again in the similar pit, but one protected with a wire fencing. They had to watch over the protected nest to prevent thefts. In the first year, we could successfully protect 15 nests in the manner when the babies hatched out of the eggs. What an event that was! The whole village rushed to the beach to witness the spectacle. When the tiny turtle hatchlings hurried across the silver sands to meet the rolling, boundless sea, what an ovation they received from the onlookers. Onlookers means that means they were non-participating people who were just observing. Some of the elder villagers confessed that though they had seen and stolen turtle eggs right from their school days, it was for the first time they had seen the hatchlings rushing to the sea. So even they were surprised to see that how the hatchlings came out of the egg. There are 7 types of sea turtles in the world, 5 of which are found in India. So the author is now describing about the types of the sea turtles. There are seven types. The olive ridley turtles nest along the entire coastline of Maharashtra. Green turtles and hogbills have also been found. An amazing characteristic of turtles is that when a female turtle reaches maturity, that is nearly after a gap of 15 years, she returns to the shore to lay her eggs at the same place where she was born. The female comes onto the shore just to make a nest in the sand and lay her eggs and immediately returns to the sea. She does not return to the nest after that. See how very interesting fact this is. The eggs hatch after a period of 45 to 50 days using natural heat. Innumerable dangers await the little hatchlings in the deep sea, and they have to face them all on their own, and their survival rate is therefore as low as just one or two turtles out of 1,000. Turtles perform an important function. They keep the sea clean. Even the turtles have the important task in the cycle of the ecosystem. They clean the sea. Thus, they occupy an important place in the marine ecology. Considering all these factors, it is vital to undertake their protection on a large scale. After the success at Villas, we started implementing the project in other places too. This was their first initiative, and then afterward they started the same project in the various places. Within 5 years, the entire coastline of Maharashtra was surveyed and protection was offered in 80 of the villages where the turtle nests were found. Our strategy was to engage those who had so far been involved in killing the eggs, then to train and involve them in the work of protection. We started the Turtle Friend Award Kasa Mitra to encourage more people to be the part of the protection campaign. A comprehensive booklet and a short film on the protection of turtles was prepared to spread the message. The year 2006 saw the beginning of the novel concept Turtle Festival or Kasa Mahotsava, an opportunity for tourists to witness the unique spectacle of hatchlings rushing out to the sea. A short film on turtles and the natural beauty of Konkan were additional features of the festival. At the same time, we were quite firm on one issue: the hatchlings should not come to even the slightest harm due to this tourist activity. So this thing was being kept in mind. It was adhered that no turtle is being harmed while such activity is going on or during the turtle festival. The tourists were accommodated in the homes of the villagers. Now even the accommodation was required, so where they will be accommodated. So these tourists were accommodated at the homes of the villagers, and the response to this novel concept of homestay was excellent. From there only the concept of the homestay came into existence. A turtle friends club was established in each village. So regarding this, that as everything was being planned, so initiative to carry on this, a turtle friends club was established in each village, and the members being all the villagers offering homestay. So that was also even a kind of source of income to them. All villages would now offer the same rate for homestay. They gave 10% of their income from homestay for the turtle protection fund. Whatever income they earn, out of that, they used to give 10% for the turtle protection fund. And in every house, wherever the accommodation was offered for the homestay, the rate or the tariff was same. They kept same. The fund would be utilized for purpose of protection and conservation of turtles. Modern technology also helped the festival reach all the corners of the world through the medium of internet and website. People around the world began to contact small villages. Of Konkan, more and more villagers came forward to do this work, and the number of the homestay families went up to 35. Now see, the day by day it went on increasing. as many as 800 people begin to visit villas in the turtle season. So 800 people almost visited. This means that more and more business for the villagers. Now they realize that tourism can be a source of income. Instead of robbing the eggs and then eating or selling in the market and then only acquiring a little sum of money, they realized that tourism was the best business for them. Tourists bring in money, and in order to earn that money, it was important to protect the turtle hatchlings. This was conservation of nature through livelihood. That means what? In this, by taking care of the turtles, both the ends were being met. One, they earn money, and second thing this endangered species, that is a turtle, it was being conserved. That means at one time, both have been adhered to. In its true sense, villas became the project's main success story. Sayadi Nisar Mitra, our organizing them, believe that it is only the local villagers who can ultimately offer excellent protection to the local species. If they are given the freedom to do that, the conservation projects become sustainable. It can go on for a long period of time. It will be very successful if they involve the villagers in it. And the villagers thought that if they are getting a good source of income, and then if they are able to survive certain species by helping nature, so in all it was beneficial for everybody. With this belief, we entrusted the project to the forest department, the Gram Panchayat, the villagers and the Turtle Friends Club. All of them are handling it wonderfully. So the author at the end realized that after entrusting them the project to forest department, the Gram Panchayat, the villagers and the Turtle Friends Club, they were handling it wonderfully. They were creating miracles. Now we are happy to see the project running smoothly. And then they were observing also after entrancing. They did not left it like this only. They even looked at that the project was running very smoothly and offer help only when it is necessary. And they were ready to even offer the help whenever it was necessary. Hope you all have understood the chapter very well. Now in this chapter, here I have given the clauses is given, the main clause. Now in this you have to identify the main clause. The sole examples are given here. Thank you.